My name is Yam. Yam means sea in Hebrew, like the ocean. I grew up in a city called Givatayim, something like 5 minutes away from Tel Aviv, the big city of Israel.
Yam was an amazing little kid, very energetic.
Yam was running all around all the time. You couldn't stop him.
Start to walk at 7 or 8 months, all of a sudden, and didn't stop from then.
I started skating when I was 4 years old. This is when I got my first skateboard for my 4th birthday as a present. I was playing soccer in one of the biggest teams in Israel, like the kids team, Hapoel Tel Aviv, which is also my favorite soccer team. I was also competing in surfing. My dad, he's a surfer since he was a kid. It was just natural. Every Saturday when we've had a soccer game, my dad put the closest skate park on the GPS and we go there. It doesn't matter if I feel tired or it doesn't matter if I feel sad or happy. We're going because this is what I wanted to do the most and this is what I was waiting for.
It's not that Yam chose skateboarding, it's I think skateboarding chose Yam.
I loved playing soccer, but I definitely loved skating more. At some point, I felt like I'm doing the wrong thing. I hated going to practices. The coach was like telling me to do something that I didn't believe I have to do to get better. I just felt like I'm doing something that I don't 100% feel comfortable with. When you're 13, you're switching between the kids team to the actual youth team, and then it becoming way more serious. And I just felt like I want to try and take skating as far as I can. I have freedom in skateboarding. Around 2007, Grindline built the first big concrete skate park in Tel Aviv. I loved every moment of skating in that bowl. I just felt like I found myself. Right when I wanted to take skateboarding more seriously, it was very questionable because there were only a couple guys, maybe two, that have made a career out of skating from Israel. When I was around 17 years old, one night I've had a very, very, very hard mental breakdown. I've tried to commit suicide. I felt like I just couldn't do it anymore. It was a big risk, and I just didn't know how to take all this stress. That night was something I will definitely remember for the rest of my life. I woke my parents up. The next morning we went to my therapist, and the therapist said, listen, if you were under 18, I would send you straight to mental health hospital because you need to be there. The first thing I asked him was, if I'm going to this hospital, will I be able to skate? And he said, no. And I just replied, I'm not going. I couldn't do anything by myself, only with people that knew about the situation and knew about what I was going through. And my parents and the therapists were trusting them.
Skateboarding is a very, very good way to overcome any issues in childhood and also mental issues, because when you're skateboarding, you must concentrate all of you in what you are doing in the moment. You cannot think about anything.
I just wanted to skate. This is the only thing I wanted to do because this what was clearing my mind every time. At that time, this was the only thing I was doing. I was waking up in the morning. My friend that my parents were trusting was picking me up and he was making sure I'm skating from day to night, every day.
You can learn from the difficulties that you have in the skate park. You can take those lessons to the life. It helped Neam a lot to overcome his difficulties and become the man he is.
I truly believe skateboarding saved my life.
It's a blessing that someone can do something that he loves the most and also make a living out of it.
This partnership with P448 came up, and it was just insane because I've never expected anything like that to happen so quick. It was the most incredible feeling of my life. I felt like I'm working so hard and it's getting paid off. I started working with Wayne at first, who is the owner of the company, and also the designers from the paper plane workshop. They flew me out to Italy and we just started pitching ideas how we want a skate shoe to look or to be or to feel. And at first, I didn't know that this is going to be my first pro model. Then we started working on logos. It was just the most exciting thing of my life. I saw some materials at the headquarters, and then I saw one shoe at the back of all those shoes that they've had. And it was looking like a skate shoe. I liked how they look. I put them on the table, and I was like, we're gonna work with this shoe. Tried them out, felt good at first, and then I realized that we need to make them more flexible. So we started working on different materials and different soles. I figured out one outsole that I liked, and then we started working on how strong they will be, you know, because you don't want a skate shoe to like get ripped after two sessions. Then we started working like the actual design of the shoe and what will be good for skating or what will be bad for skating. And the insole, we got into the smallest details. Obviously, after that, we started working on the colorways. I wanted the shoes to say, this is Yam. And I took a lot of ideas. For example, my favorite soccer team or what my name means, which is sea, like the ocean. We started working with the color blue. Tel Aviv area, like the city, the colors of the city. Then we took the colors that I like to wear the most. I wanted to make sure that all those shoes that we're making, I will want to wear every single day. And we just did it. It was sick, it was so cool. When I saw my first shoe, I was looking at it, my mom was right next to me, my sister was filming it. It felt like a dream. When I was 14, my dad took me to my first contest outside of Israel. I've seen people spinning 540s for the first time in my life. It was just insane. I didn't know if I will ever be able to do that type of tricks. Something in my mind told me to keep going and keep trying. I think 2 years later, I got my first 540.
Honestly, I don't know if there's anyone else on Israel like Yam. I think it's pretty crazy that he's pushed himself to where he's at now with skateboarding. It seems like in the last few years they've built a lot more parks that would be better for him to learn at, but it's still crazy to think that he's gotten to where he's at with what he has.
I always set myself a goal that I will take all my family to one contest. In the first Olympic qualifier for Paris 2024 in Dubai, I decided to surprise them and buy them all tickets to come and be with me and experience all of this with me. I remember looking at them right before I was dropping in for my second run, which I needed to land this run if I wanted to qualify. Landed my run, watched their faces. My sisters were crying. My mom was about to cry. My dad didn't even want to look because he was so stressed. One of my greatest memories from skating so far, for sure.
לדעתי, ים, מה שהופך אותו למיוחד, זה שהוא תמיד נופל וקם בסקייטבורד, ואם זה בחיים בכלל, חלום, יש לו מטרות, יש לו מטרה אחת גדולה, וזה להגיע לאולימפיאדה.
I know that not a lot of people has the opportunity to try to make it to the Olympics. Olympics is like the biggest stage in sports history, basically. It's stressful, but I'm very thankful for it.
Right now I'm doing all Olympic qualifier events, and each event has a different impact on my road to the Olympics. Basically, we have world championships and pro tour stops. I need to stay in the top 44 to qualify for the next round for our spot for the Olympics.
Yam is a really good competitor. He definitely puts his work in and gets ready for the event, kind of calculates out like what he needs to do, and he makes it happen.
When I heard that skating is getting to the Olympics, it definitely affected me because skating is finally getting as recognized as it should be. You can see after the Tokyo Olympics, skating is like one of the biggest things right now all over the world. Everyone's skating, everyone wants to skate.
I always tell Yam, we must enjoy the way. If we enjoy the way and in the end qualify to the Olympic, it's a great goal, but I think that it's amazing, the journey also.
Obviously, I want and hope I will make it to Paris 2024, but even if I'm not, I will never stop skating because it's the thing I love to do the most.